Excuse me, what are you holding? You're holding two bags of popcorn? Why, isn't that funny? Because the rules for movie night state that you can only have one bag of popcorn. That's right, one bag of popcorn per person. By having two bags of popcorn, you are violating that rule. Do you know what that means? You are depriving somebody of their privilege to have popcorn. I am very disappointed in you. It is frankly insulting that you refuse to follow even the movie night rules. All right, I am done with you. Oh, what's that? You're just holding your friend's popcorn? Huh? No, you're a liar. I don't buy that for a second. You've been lying your entire life. You're just a filthy liar. Excuse me, miss. Excuse me. They're holding two bags of popcorn instead of one. And you know what that means? That means someone in the audience does not have a bag of popcorn. I'm going to go to the principal about this because this is not right and this is not fair.
Hi, everyone. Hi, I'm Emily. I know you guys don't know me, but like, I'm humble. So, okay. Where do I begin? Every morning, I would waddle up to Edward's classroom. Okay, well, he didn't let me call him that, but now he's dead. So, I gave him an apple and a grande vanilla latte. Skinny. He knew he had a good figure.
Ew.
I have fond memories of the deep conversations we had. He told me everything. How he wasn't happy in his marriage and how he wishes he could leave the troll goblin woman that he was with. Something like that. It was something like more medieval, but I... Sorry, are you his wife? Ah, I don't see the mole. Anyway, well, may God give him rest in heaven. Hopefully. Anyway, good night, Chicago! Mr.
Oh my gosh, it's so short. Oh my gosh, there's no hair there. Excuse me, notice anything different? What, you don't? Honestly, frankly, that's actually kind of frankly rude. Frankly, I had a mental breakdown last night and I cut off a whole inch. Isn't that crazy? OMG. Jake, can't you tell? My hair is different. I'm a different girl now, Jake. Jake, hit me up. I can't believe you didn't notice. Oh my gosh, my hair is so short.
Excuse me, as I was leaving school yesterday, do you know what I found on your desk? Your chemistry notebook. Now, why was your chemistry notebook on your desk instead of in your backpack? Oh, you lost it yesterday? Well, here it is. How could you lose something as important as your chemistry notebook? This should be your life. You should not lose this. Wait. If this was with me last night, how did you do your chemistry homework? You didn't do it? Wow, I don't know if I could be your friend anymore. Whew. Oh, what's that? You want me to give you your notebook back? Oh, I'd be happy to do that. On one condition. You do last night's homework and an extra, I don't know, 30 textbook problems. And if you get them all right, I'd be happy to give this notebook back to you. Because, sadly, there's a rule called finders, keepers, losers, weepers. And that basically means that if I find something, I get to keep it. And since you're the loser in this scenario, you can go weep and do your textbook problems, okay?
Hey everybody, hi, I am Maria. I don't know why we have to do introductions because it's like so stupid, but like anyway, it's fine, no offense. Okay, so my project today is going to be on George Washington. Let me just get my glasses really quickly. No, they're not prescription, they're just really cute. Okay, so George Washington was the first president of the United States. Josh, please stop. Josh, stop. Oh my God, Parker, stop. You guys are crazy. Anyway, so if anybody has any questions, does anybody have any questions? Nobody? Okay, perfect, thanks.
So let me get this straight. You're not coming to the gender reveal. Whose wife is it anyway?
Oh my God, your uncle?
He's had cancer for 20 years, honey. Don't you want to see the confetti cannon? It's like you don't care if he's going to be a soccer player or a ballerina.
It's like you don't even care.
So you don't want to see if pink or blue balloons are going to come out of a FedEx box in my backyard?
Do you know how much Braxton spent on a confetti cannon?
A lot of money. And you're not going to be there.
He's like, you're not going to be there for my wife.
I just don't know how this baby's gonna consider you an auntie. Well, I hope you enjoy your uncle's wake. Gender is something the person defines for themselves.
No, sweetie, I think it's the confetti cannon, actually. Yeah, which you're gonna miss.
I think it's the balloon. I think it's the pink or blue balloon.
We even got cupcakes.
cupcakes. Like it! The cupcakes are supposed to say ruffles or rifles, not ruffles or riddles. What the hell? It just hurts because you were supposed to take the Instagram picture.
Excuse me? What are you doing over here? The gym teacher sent you over here? Well, you can tell the gym teacher that there is no way I am participating in the game of dodgeball. Dodgeball is a barbaric sport. I'm going to stand here in the corner and read my book in peace and quiet. And if it impacts my grade in any way, I will be heading to the principal about this. Because I am not required to play dodgeball, alright? You go ahead and tell the gym teacher that. And while you're at it, why don't you move to the other side of the gym instead of standing right in front of me? Because someone could throw a ball and it could hit me. And I don't want to get hit with a ball because that hurts. Ah! Ow. Who threw that ball? That's it. Who threw that ball? Someone fess up right now, or else. This is your last warning. Fess up, or else I will go to the principal. No one's fessing up? Okay. Excuse me, Miss Gym Teacher. I'm going to the principal, and I'm reporting this entire class for being mean.